with a nun sequitur. Oh. How do you get urine off a nun?
I don't think that nuns pee at all.
Oh.
I know a lot about nuns.
Do you? Why is that?
Because I was educated by them and I was in a boarding school, so I actually lived with them.
Right, and they never weed?
Never. I never saw one of them enter or leave a bathroom.
The thing is, they've got those very long frocks on, haven't they?
Very long frocks, and they might have some kind of divine catheter or something, but they don't...
The Divine Catheter are a great group, aren't they?
For anybody at home playing QI bingo, that's Divine Catheter.
In the 18th century, women who wore the long frocks, they used to have the equivalent of a gravy boat on a sort of ribbon for long church services.
They actually had one of those things that we were all just imagining.
Yes, they did. They actually did.
A gravy boat on a ribbon.
Yeah.
Is this urine in the picture, or is that just something that...
The gravy boat's fallen off! Help me!
So that's... The gravy boat's fallen off.
Is it necessary to get urine off nuns?
It was necessary. It was the 1960s, OK?
Oh, it was a condiment, wasn't it, nunwee?
A condiment?
That's right. Have you got a slightly bigger bottle of nunwee?
Was it to test pregnancy tests?
It's to do with pregnancy, OK. So women who go through the menopause, their urine contains very high levels of hormones that can be used to make medications to increase female fertility. So that's something that, obviously, the Roman Catholic Church very much in favour of.
Hence the horny menopausal women.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
It's another good group. The horny menopausal women. I love that band. What a gig.
1960, there was a medical student called Bruno Lunenfeld, and he was looking for a source of menopausal women who would be happy to give up their urine. So, this is one of those stories where chance takes a moment in life. He met the Pope's nephew by chance, right? And he's talking about, where the heck am I going to find a whole lot of menopausal women who don't mind about giving up their urine, who are going to help with fertility drugs? And it was the Vatican. And he said, I was lucky enough to have a unique connection to an important authority with access to a huge supply of post-menopausal urine.
See, they've got their bag, their colostomy bag. Yes, they've disguised as handbags, haven't they? Boldly worn on the outside.
Plain sight.
Well, here's the thing that might interest you. Did you know that in the United States it's now possible to rent a nun?
I'd say that might be becoming a thing world over, because there's bound to be a shortage.
Well, we're busy. We're all very busy.
We haven't
got time to pray every day. So, the Salesian Sisters of St. John Bosco, they run an Adopt-A-Sister programme. You have to give about $500 for the sister's retirement needs, and then she will pray for you every day, saving you the bother.
Will she do light admin as well? I mean, obviously, do the prayer, but also, if you could just sort of give the study a once-over, that sort of thing.
A bit of laundry. They're great at the laundry.
Do you think there's a thing about lots of women living in close cloisters like that? Because in 1844, there was an extraordinary experience when a French nun began to meow like a cat, OK? And soon, the other nuns joined in, and eventually, every nun in the convent was meowing for hours on end, and they couldn't stop. And do you know how they stopped in the end?
Got a dog.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.